Hi, I'm Stephen, and welcome to today's super quick video where we set a gas blowtorch against some pieces of diesel particulate filter. Let's get straight to it. I've opened up an old diesel particulate filter and cut it into pieces, and now I've set them up ready to be blasted by over 1000 degrees Celsius or 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. The black residue is soot or oily soot, and anything with a red color is ash. Soot is supposed to burn off as a normal function of a working filter, but ash is something that builds up over the years and eventually means that the diesel particulate filter needs to be removed for cleaning. Let's see if some extreme temperature will remove both soot and ash. Quick warning, don't try this at home without high temperature safety equipment. End of warning. We have here the full front section of the diesel particulate filter. We also have a little piece here that is very covered in oily soot, but also has some of the channels blocked by ash. And finally, we have this piece, which doesn't have much in the way of black soot, but it does have quite a few channels blocked with red coloured ash. We'll try the largest piece first, and we'll hit it with the gas burner. This is the type of burner that is used to melt on bitumen type roofing. One and a half minutes have passed, let's have a look. With a bit more exposure on the camera, we can see that the black soot is gone, leaving just the red ash residue everywhere. Second, we'll blast this clean-looking piece for a minute. Finally, let's blast this small soot-covered piece for a minute. Wow, that whole piece is glowing red. That's got to be over 1200 degrees Celsius, or 2200 degrees Fahrenheit. And the result is, for this small piece, the ash is still glowing red, but it hasn't gone anywhere. Even the extreme temperatures won't remove ash buildup from a diesel particulate filter. And we can see here the same results on a slightly larger section. There is no soot here, but you can see clearly that the channels are still blocked with ash. So the conclusion to all this is that extreme heat is not a suitable method to rejuvenate an end-of-life ash-clogged filter. It is, however, very effective at burning away soot in the filter. So there is a chance that a gas burner could be used to bring a completely soot-clogged filter back to life as an alternative to sending it away to be baked overnight in a high-temperature oven. If your car's engine is working properly, then soot will be burned off as part of the normal diesel particulate filter regeneration. But if some system has failed on your car, there is a possibility that a filter can be so blocked that your engine won't even run. And then there is no choice but to take the filter out for soot removal. Although we can see that this DIY extreme heat method works on small pieces, I wouldn't want to speculate about whether it can work successfully on a full DPF that is still in its steel housing. A test for another day, perhaps. Until next time.